Once you receive your shipment of chairs, you're going to get boxes with different parts in them. The first box you'll get will have your back in those. So you have a box with backs. You'll have a box that comes with your seat. And you'll have a box full of your legs. Notice when you receive your product, you'll have an attached baggie full of your hardware that you'll need to install your chairs. Make sure you look for this. If for some reason it's not installed on the chair, make sure you please check your box to make sure it hadn't fallen off or it got thrown in the box that way. So these are all the parts you will need and accessories you'll need to install your chairs. Okay, your first step is we're dealing with a 21-inch chair, so we have to mount our legs on 21-inch centers. Now I've already taken the liberty here to go ahead and install these two legs on this base. And as you can see here, I'll zoom in, and you can see the center leg there is at 21 inches, okay? So from that center leg all the way to this center leg, you need to be at 21 inches. Once you've done this step, then follow through to your next step. All right, you see here your leg here. You want to go ahead and install before you put your back on. Your first step is to put, you have 2/4-inch 20 bolts and nuts here. You're going to want to put that through the bottom hole of each standard. So the bottom of this one and your bottom of your other side. Put those in, leave them loose, because the back you'll see in a second has a little slot. You just slide right on top of this. So do this step next and then follow through to your next step. All right, our Ruby Marquee, this is a 21-inch back. As you can see, here's the ear we're going to use to mount to the leg. You have a slotted end at the bottom. You have three holes at the top. We recommend you using the center hole as your mounting area. You can use the front or back hole depending on the relaxed or more upright position depending on your comfort level. So once you've decided where you want to put that, you're going to take your back and you're going to slide it on your ears at the bottom. The nut should already, bolt shorter should be there for you. Then you're going to take your back bolt and nut and you're going to stick it through the center hole. And take your nut and put it on. And you're going to follow the same step on the other side. Once you've done this, you can you'll use a 7/16 head socket, or you can use a wrench. In this case, I got one that goes on my drill. You'll tighten these bolts down. All right, this is our seat to our Ruby Marquee. As you can see, there's an ear on the side of the chair. This particular ear will mount onto the bottom mount of the leg itself. So we'll set that right on top there. Okay, on each side. Once you've done that, you have 2 7/16 by 1 inch bolt. They drop through on each side. You also are giving 2 flange nuts that will go on the bottom of these nuts. You'll put those on, and then once you've done this, it will tighten everything down and you'll have a secure chair. Keep in mind when you install this chair, and most times you're not ordering just one chair, you're getting multiple chairs. This particular style chair, the legs share backs. So in this case, you would tighten up this one side. This particular bolt on each side is going to share a back. So you'll leave the bottom one on. The top one's going to share, so you're going to put your next back on before you put this bolt in. If you don't do that, you'll have a hard time trying to get it to stay. So once you put your nuts on, you tighten your back up and you'll be good to go. This is what your Ruby Marquee will look like once it's fully installed. As you can see, it has a flip-up seat. And I hope these instructions have helped you install your home theater needs. From all of us at seatsandchairs.com, hope you enjoy your chairs.